30th September 2006, the day the Kodachrome factory in Lausanne, Switzerland closed its doors for business. This day was the end of Super 8 film processing in Europe. The ritual of shooting a 3-minute wonder on my Super 8 camera, sending off the cartridge in a little yellow envelope, and then waiting with barely contained excitement for the reel of film to drop on the doormat, is over. Kodachrome was actually black and white stock, to which colour was added during the processing. This gave the film its kaleidoscope charm, making anything look as though it was in some childhood Technicolor dreamland from 1971. But it was also expensive to process. Its manufacturers, Kodak, had been running the Kodachrome processing plant as a loss-making enterprise for years, since video camcorders, then digital cameras, and film editing software arrived on the scene. I used to take my Super 8 camera everywhere, to places as near and far as Newcastle and New York, St. John's Wood and St. Petersburg, Birmingham and Buenos Aires. Somehow, looking back on a projector makes the memories more real, more lasting. Digital film just doesn't come with scratches, hairlines or built-in rose-tinted spectacles. You can use a computer to deteriorate it, but it just looks fake. Only Super 8 has that romantic, worn quality. It has a roughness that no other medium possesses. Now, a year later, and Super 8 cartridges are increasingly hard to get hold of. Even if you can find somewhere to buy one, you then have to send it somewhere like California or Kansas to get it developed, and just hope for the best. Of course, there's still plenty of Super 8 cameras clogging up attics, charity shops, and car boot sales across the world. But as time marches on, the possibility of repair and the availability of spare parts diminishes. It looks like that tragic prerequisite of capitalist progress, the inevitable upgrade, means we've reached the end of the reel for Super 8.